Dan, would you like to present your request?
Yes, I'm here. Daniel Seaman, Lebanon County Assessment Office, here on behalf of the for the Board of Assessments. We have 5 appeals outstanding, and we have discussed adjusted values for those appeals with each property owner. And I just need your approval on those. And then I also do have 2 exemption requests. So the appeals themselves are, and I hope you have the information that I sent yesterday. We're able to look at those, look at that information. The first one is number 2020-84, and it is 109 Ann Valley Drive. And we discussed a adjusted value down to $505,900.
Is there any are there any questions, or is there a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion to approve the recommended value.
I'll second the motion.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
The next one is 2020-85. That's 500 East Main Avenue, and they agreed to or looked at an adjusted value of $671,200.
And in what town is that?
Oh, that's in Myerstown.
Myerstown. Okay. Are there any questions, or is there a motion?
I'll second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
2020-86 is 735 Mechanic Street, and that's in Lebanon. And the adjusted value there is $213,900.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
2020-87. Is at 1036 Kathleen Street in Lebanon, and the adjusted value there is $95,300.
Also move.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
And the last appeal is 2020-88, and that's at 13 Green Acres, and adjusted value there is $22,200.
So move.
I'll second the motion.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Dan, you have exemptions as well?
Yes, I have 2 exemption requests. And the first one is Seventh-day Adventist Church up at 370 North 7th Street in the city. And it's a church, and they have regularly stated religious services. And also in this building, they have several apartments, and Carl reviewed those, and those apartments are not being used for any income or anything at this point. So we may review that down the road in a few years just to make sure. But in talking with Solicitor Dave Warner, he has recommended that. This board exemption.
I'm sorry, was it approved for exemption?
Yes, approved for exemption.
I'll move that we approve the Seventh-day Adventist request.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Okay, and the other one is a property owned by Summit International School of Ministry. It's at 74 Harrison School Road out near Grantville. And it is used for housing for employees for the Summit School. And what they do there is the compensation that the residents get from the Summit School of Ministry is part, this housing is part of that. So pretty much, they live there rent-free and work at Summit School of Ministry. And speaking with the solicitor again, he has recommended that we approve this for exemption.
Based on the solicitor's recommendation, I move that we give them an exemption.
I'll second the motion.
I do have a question, Dan. Thank you, gentlemen. I just remember this coming up a couple of times before. What is different between before and now?
We've approved some in the past, and we haven't approved some in the past. The main difference was depending on who was occupying and how much compensation they received, and if they were paying any kind of rent. At this one, they are not paying any rent at all. Their compensation for working is living in the house.
Okay. So it all. What if the terms of the leases change?
I guess I would have to defer to Dave on that one. I guess we could review it. We could review it yearly, I guess. So.
Yeah, if I may, Commissioner Letts?
Yes, please.
Yeah, we always run into these gray areas on some of these properties where there's a potential for a mixed use or mixed purpose. Like, even initially on this property, I think there was some indication that maybe there was a partial rent being paid, or maybe some of the units, there was some additional rent for a significant other or spouse to reside there. But then the clarification came back from the property owner that it was solely for the use of the employee and just for, and again, in exchange of compensation. So the lines here are kind of gray and messy. And we always run into this situation where potentially the property owner could change, slightly modify the use or terms. And there's no real mechanism for us to be in the loop and be aware of that immediately. We really would have to schedule these for some kind of regular review, request a recertification from the property owner that they're still maintaining the exemption status.
So Dan's suggestion carries value, and we can pass the motion providing him the opportunity to conduct an annual review.
Okay.
That would be fine with me.
Is that an approved amendment to your motion, Commissioner?
Yes, sir.
I heard a confirmation from both. So that being said, we'll if there are no questions, we'll call for the vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you. Is there anything else, Dan?
No, that should do it. That we'll do our yearly review on this.
Thank you. Can I have
okay.
a motion
Thank
to,
you.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Motion to adjourn.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you, gentlemen. Motion carries.